Okay, dear my students, so today I want to show you another seed purity analysis. That means how we can determine the percentage of purity of the seeds. From collection of the sample, so after collection, then we have to proceed for the germination test, viability test, or whatever test we do. Before that, we have to test the purity. How much pure, whether any mixture of any other seeds, or any weed seeds, any other plant particles or any inert material. So we have to separate one by one, and at the end we have to determine the percentage of pure seeds. So this is called the purity bolt. So this is the power glass here. So in between where we want to use, so there is the power cable. So make it when we switch one, so you can see the light. And we can, this is our the mixer of seed. For the practical purpose, we have just mixed different types of seed and inert matter. But in the practically, so just we have to collect from the field after harvesting or after processing, then we have to determine the percentage collecting the sampling. So last time I have already shown you the how to do the sampling. So from the working sample, we have to do the first analysis is the purity analysis. So how to do it? So firstly, we have to weigh the total amount. Suppose, for example, this is 100 grams of the entire seed is 100 gram. So we have to put on the purity board. So after that, there's a power glass, you can see easily. So make it so the size is bigger. So our main seed is rice seed. So from here, we have to separate one by one what type of other materials inside. So for the pure seed, this rice is the pure seed. So we have to remember that the shrivel is the, that means the deformed or even germinated rice seed also considered as pure seed. And even the rice, the broken one, if the size is more than half, then it also considered pure seed. If less than half, then inert matter. So suppose I can show you here, so some of the rice particle is less than half, so you have to consider these are inert matter, not the pure seed. So this is other crop seed, this is mung bean seed, so you have to keep in another pot. Okay, so one by one, this is inert, this is rice, but more than half, so we can consider this one as a pure. So this one is another crop seed, this one also another crop seed. So we have to separate one by one. Okay, so this one is a stone particle. So a stone particle we are considered as an inert matter, or any other plant parts also considered as inert matter. If any weed seed, we have also have to separate as weed seed. So there are several sections. So we are using the power glass because the size is showing very bigger, so very easy to separate. Okay, one by one. So this is see less than half, so we have to consider this one as inert matter. Okay, so you can see this one is more than half, so we have to consider as a pure, but this one is the inert matter, maybe other plant parts, so we have to consider this one as inert matter. So all these are the other crop seeds. So we have to one by one, you have to separate. In the practicable, sometimes majority of the crops, the wheat seed, they can mix with the main crop. So you have to separate them separately. So these are also other crop parts. So you can see broken part, whether they have the ovule or not, but if less, more than half, then we have to consider they are other, that means the pure seed. Okay. So by this way, we have to do the purity analysis of the seed. This is some of the inert part, that is plant parts or husk. These are, you can see they are attached with the, so this one also as inert matter. This one also other crop seed. Just for example, we have tried to mix here the different type of seed. but in practically mostly there have wheat seed and some other crops may have. Okay, so you can see now almost these are the pure sample. So this one is the pure sample, so we have to separate that. We have already separated. This one is the other crop seed, this one is the inert matter, the other any parts, whether sand particle, the stone particle, or any parts of the crops, or the broken part less than half. So after that, what you have to do? So you have to collect the seed, all this. You have to wait again the main seed, main pure seed, then you have to wait that one, you have to wait also that one. If there have any wheat seed, you have to separate in the separate bowl or separate petri dish. After that, we have to wait to measure the percentage, because for example, I have taken 100 gram of the entire seed. Now we have to wait everyone how much their weight. Then after that, we have to use the equation there. You can see the equation. So how to measure the percentage? So the percentage of pure seeds. So that is weight of individual compounds. That means if it is the after purity analysis, if this one is the pure seed and the total weight of the seed, that is 100 gram and the separated pure seed multiplied by 100. So that means the percent of pure seeds in the several way. In the other ways, so you have to find other crop seed how many percentage, inert matter the percentage, and wheat seeds how much percentage using the same equation. So by this way, we can determine the purity percentage of the seed. So this is the first analysis before going for the further analysis like viability test, germination test. So this is all about the purity analysis. So thank you, everyone.